So, again, just a quick overview of yesterday's class. Diffusion was the movement of the solute molecules across a permeable membrane, a semi-permeable membrane, and osmosis was the movement of solvent molecules across the semi-permeable membrane. So ultimately, the direction of these two will be different if we are talking of the same system. The diagram is still there on the board. If you haven't understood, you can refer to the diagram like this. You can draw it in your notebook and make it yourself more clear about these two concepts of osmosis and diffusion. Now, why does the osmosis happen? It is because of the osmotic pressure. And this pressure is nothing but a minimum pressure that must be exerted to prevent a passage of pure solvent into the solution and where these two are separated by the semi-permeable membrane. It means nothing but wherever there is a dilute solution and if the concentrated solution and both of these dilute and concentrated solution, they are separated by a semi-permeable membrane, the solvent will flow from dilute solution because there is a kind of minimum pressure that is exerted to prevent the passage of pure solvent into the solution that is concentrated to dilute. That is not happening, but rather the dilute to concentrated is happening, and that allowing that passage is done by inhibiting the opposite movement. Again, we need not go into the complexity of this, but you can simply remember it as the pressure that is exerted to prevent the passage of pure solvent into the solution. Yeah, so that is the osmotic pressure, and usually. Osmotic pressure of a solution is the measure of tendency to take in water by the process of water by the process of osmosis. So that is the pressure. So whatever ability or tendency of that particular system or a cell is to take in water, that is measured as osmotic pressure. And it's relatively again a simpler concept. Like I said, we need not go into the physics behind it. Otherwise, there is quite a lot to discuss the molecular movement, the Newtonian motion, and so on. But we need not talk about this here at all. So, osmotic pressure is the simple measure of tendency to take in water by the process of osmosis. Now, based on what is the concentration difference, the solutions, they are, or what is called as osmotic solutions, they are called as. Like they are divided into three types. Now, what are osmotic solutions? First of all, whenever there is a solute dissolved in some solvent, that is called as osmotic solution. Nothing else. Osmos, it refers to some solute molecules being present in the solvent molecule forming a solution type of material. So that is osmotic solution, which is of three types: isotonic, hypertonic, and hypotonic. Now, isotonic is like again, imagine a compartment system where there are two compartments which are separated by a semi-permeable membrane. In one of the compartment, there is a solution. In another compartment, there is a similar solution. And both of them, they have same concentration of solute that is inside as well as outside, or in this case, in both the compartment. They will be called as isotonic. Iso means same. Tonicity refers to the amount of solute present in the solvent, right? So when there is same amount of solute present in left as well as right compartment, that will be called as isotonic solution. So let's say, for example, again, you have a kind of rectangular box. In between, there is a partition of semi-permeable membrane. And you add 10 ml of water on both sides, and you add 1 gram of salt on both sides. They both these compartments, they will be called as isotonic because the amount of solute as well as amount of solvent is same there. So that is isotonic. Yeah. There are other situations of isotonicity as well, but again, we need not go into those details. Isotonicity is the same amount of solute per solvent present in particular compartment. That is isotonic. and hypertonic, that means higher, hyper is more or higher. So hypertonic solution, it will be one that has higher solute concentration than the other compartment, or in this case, if the inside of the cell has higher solute than the outside, or the outside has higher solute than the inside, either ways, that respective compartment will be called as hypertonic. So wherever there is higher concentration will be called hypertonic, and wherever there is lower concentration will be called as hypotonic. I will just take a quick brief introduction on the board, because these are again important concepts to know. So the safe system over one. Okay, so again, imagine my board is not so clean. Okay. Yeah. And I will draw it in two different ways. One is the compartment phase. Again, imagine, let's say this is compartment 1, compartment 2. They are part of the same system, right? Let's say there is same amount of water and there are same amount of solute molecules. This will be called as isotonic. Or in other case, like I said, there are various ways of solution being isotonic. I reduce the water in one of the compartments. I make it to half. Let's say this is half. And I reduce the solute also to half. They are also isotonic, because the number of solute per molecule of solvent, they are same. So isotonicity is not the exact volumes. Isotonicity is the same amount of solute per solvent molecule, right? I reduce the water also to half. I reduce the solute also to half. They are also isotonic. I hope this part is clear. Normally, we show isotonicity like this. That is, having the same solute as well as same solvent. Then, so that is isotonicity. Now, in case of hypertonicity, compartment 1 is hypertonic, compartment 2 is hypotonic. So that means hypertonic means higher or more. This compartment 1 has more number of solute molecules compared to something, that is compartment. And compartment 2 has lower number of solute molecule compared to number 1, and that is why this is hypotonic, this hypertonic. Now, how is it true in other scenarios? So for example, let's say this is the cell. I'm not drawing anything with the cell. Now, imagine there is plasma membrane and everything else, nucleus and all. Let's say there is cytoplasm and there are certain, let me just call it Na plus, Na plus, Na plus, and outside there is Na plus, Na plus, and Na plus. Now, inside of the cell and the outside of the cell, or which is called an extracellular space, both of them, they have same concentration of the sodium. There, they will be called as isotonic. Now, let's say if you reduce the concentration of sodium outside, inside of the cell is hypertonic. Outside of the cell is hypotonic. So it's always be in context. The moment you say cell is hypotonic, that means inside the cell has to be less concentration. Outside the cell has to be more concentration. The moment we say cell is hypertonic, that means inside the cell there is more whatever solid concentration, solute concentration, that is more inside the cell,
and outside is less. So it's always relative terminology. It is not an absolute terminology.
Okay, I hope that part is clear to everyone. Stop, cancel this, share the screen. Okay, and that's what these three different types of solution are. That is isotonic, hypertonic, and hypotonic. Now, again, the definition of tonicity, that is the relative concentration. Remember, this word relative is very important because it is in relation to something. Relative concentration of the solution, that will determine the direction and the extent of diffusion. Now we know both of these processes, whether it's osmosis or diffusion, both of them, they happen along the concentration gradient. One, diffusion is along the concentration gradient of solute, and osmosis is along the concentration gradient of solvent. Sorry. So that way, both of these, they are relative concentrations of the solution that will determine the direction and the extent of diffusion, and that is what is called as tonicity. And based on that, there are these three terminologies. Like the earlier what we saw was the types of solution. These are the tonicities of the solution, that is whether the solution is isotonic or hypertonic or hypotonic. It's the same, nothing different. It just the solution we call hypotonic or hypertonic or isotonic solution. And here we say the tonicity of the cell is isotonic. So there, that way there is no difference. So I'll just quickly go over it. So in case of isotonic, the relative concentration of water molecules and the solute molecules on either side of the cell membrane is same. That is on both sides, that is inside the cell as well as outside the cell. The concentration of water and the solute is same. In such solute, in such solution, there is no movement of water molecule. So whenever there is isotonic nature of the compartment, there is no gradient, right? That way there will be no movement across the cell membrane. So ultimately no osmosis or no diffusion, right? That diagram is not shown here. But yeah, on the board, when I drew the first diagram where there were six molecules of solute and equal volume of water, that is nothing but no movement of any solute or no movement of any water molecule. That is nothing but the isotonic solution. Then hypotonic, now imagine in this condition, the solution inside the cell has lower solute concentration and outside has obviously a little higher concentration. And as a result, the water molecule from outside will move to the inside, that is endosmosis. Now it is merging the concept. Which concepts? What is the way of osmosis and what is the tonicity? Both of these concepts are being merged. I'll show it in the diagram. So for example, isotonic is there, very much there. I forgot that I have it here. So in isotonic, when the solute concentration outside and inside is same, there is no net movement. Net movement is water will move outside, but then same amount of water will move us. So the total movement, or what we call as net movement, NET, that will remain same. Yeah, that will remain zero because the outside flow as well as inside flow is same. We saw hypotonic, right? Second one. Yeah, hypotonic. So in hypotonic, what happens is inside the cell, the concentration of the solute is less. Outside there is more concentration. So obviously water is going to flow from inside to outside, that is dilute solution to the concentration, so concentrated solution. No, did I do something wrong? Solution inside the cell has a lower solute concentration. That's the fluid inside the cell. The statement itself is wrong here. And the water molecule from hypotonic will allow the movement actually from lower concentration. I am myself confused. Hold on, I will use the board. I don't want to use this diagram. Otherwise, I will get confused.
Okay. So, again, if this cell we call is hypotonic, right, that means inside the cell there is less ion or less solute, and outside the cell there is more solute, right? So the water movement, now this is dilute solution inside, dilute, and this is concentrate, right? And osmosis, when it happens from dilute solution to the concentrated solution. That means wherever the water is more compared to the total system, that will allow the movement of water. So water should go out in hypotonic solutions. When the cell is hypotonic and when the outside concentration is higher, inside concentration is lower, right? So yeah, correct. This is correct. So dilute solution to concentrated solution, the water movement will happen and the cell will shrink in its size, right? Because the water from inside the cell is moving out of the cell. So that way it will shrink in size, and that particular phenomenon is called as flaccidity. Yeah, flaccidity is nothing but shrinking of the cell. And in other scenario, when again, this is the cell. Now, in this case, outside concentration is less and inside concentration is more. N plus. Now, I am randomly drawing these ions. You need not draw this. But so now, outside is dilute, inside is concentrated. Right? So that means water movement or the osmosis should happen inward. So the water from outside will move inside the cell and the cell will become turgid cell. So if this is hypertonic cell, that is the concentration inside the cell is higher, that's why hypertonic, it leads to turgidity. Now the other way to represent this is, we are talking of the inside cell is hypotonic. But if I say outside cell is hypertonic, then still the same phenomenon will come. Correct? This is, in this context, this is hypertonic. This is hypotonic. Right? When I say hypotonic here, I always say hypotonic inside the cell or hypertonic outside the cell. In this case, when I wrote hypertonic, I meant inside the cell is hypertonic and outside the cell will be hypotonic. So it's always relative what we want to show. So if it is hypotonic inside the cell, it will lead to flaccidity. Or again, in the other way, if I have to put this statement, when the cell outside has hypertonic solution, more sodium. More solute. If the cell outside has hypertonic, it will again lead to flaccidity. Same goes here. Inside cell, hypotonic lead to turbidity. Outside cell, hypotonic lead to turbidity. Context matters. So whatever you want to say, you always say inside or outside cell, and then that way you can lead to that. It's simple process of osmosis. Osmosis happens from dilute to concentration. Dilute to concentrate. Osmosis is not changing, it just the context is changing. The weight of the cell will also remain same. Yeah. So I hope you have understood this part.
Does anyone have any question there? Anyone wants to ask? People, have you slept off? Did you have a sound sleep?
So I have a question, not related to that, but concerning the project. So
concerning
the project.
Can we please take
it? Yeah, we can take it afterwards.
And I have a question. Are you paying attention in the class?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, fine. So that was related to all these three different situations. Now here, because the hypertonic or hypotonic, it is not being clearly mentioned. That's why this diagram might be confusing. Yeah. But now let's, if it is, let's say hypotonic and it is showing turgidity. That means hypotonic and turgidity. That means this hypotonic is referring to the hypotonic outside the cell and the water is moving inside. Yeah. So please put it always in context. Otherwise, these diagrams can be confusing. We will come back to this plasmolysis type of stage later. As of now, we need not call this plasmolysis. We will see that whenever we see this concept. So, the reason why I did not choose is because the context is not written. So, please refer to the diagrams from the board. I hope you have made notes of it. I guess we can stop here because I don't want to do the experiment part. Or one thing I can do for sure. Good. That reminds me. So why don't you all go through these experiments? So it's just a very simpler one. Nothing, like no brains we have to put at all. Just two simpler experiments are there. You go through them. Ideally, we should do this in the class, but then it's just like you can see, you just take a beaker, you add some solute to it, it will diffuse and you just measure the diffusion time and you check how much is the diffusion happening. So it's that simple. So you just go over this procedure, what they have done and so on. And second experiment is for osmosis. Again, the same thing is there, just with the membrane they have done. Some solute concentration you keep and you check the measure of endoosmosis as well as for the exoosmosis. So both of these processes are being mentioned here. So please go over these experiments. Not much is there, hardly 4 pages, not even 4 pages, like it's a few lines only. So please go through them on your own. I will not be taking it in the next class. I will directly start with the active transport. So that is the kind of small homework without any assignment creation. So that is on you. And I guess I will stop here as of now. If anyone has any questions, we can talk. Otherwise, you can feel free to leave.